Hello everyone, welcome to the part 2 of how to make a stopwatch and input timer like this in Gdevelop. In this part 2, I'm gonna show you how to make the input timer in Gdevelop. By the way, I'm not gonna show you all the complete tutorial like the sound or the art style. I'm just gonna show you all the necessary things to make this input timer. Step 1, create the first text input and put it on the scene. Change the input type to number. Step 2, create a scene number variable and a scene timer. I'm gonna name my variable, timer value s. I'm gonna name my scene timer, input timer. Step 3, create the first number object, put it on the scene and connect it to timer value s variable. Change the text to 0. Step 4, when the scene timer is greater than 1 second, subtract 1 to timer value s variable and start or reset the timer. Let's test it. Step 5, create the first input button and put it on the scene. I'm gonna name my input button, Enter. And put the button state behavior to the input button. And at the beginning of the scene, set the time scale to 0. Step 6, when the first input button is pressed, Connect timer value s variable to the first text input. Step 7. Create a start button and when it's pressed, set the timescale to 1. I'm gonna name my start button, Start. And put the button state behavior to the start button. Now let's test it. Step 8. Create the second number object and place it next to the first number object. Step 9. When the timer value s is greater than number 9, place the x position of the first number object to the second number object. Then delete the second number object. Step 10. When the timer value s is less than 10, place the first number object to its original position. Set it to trigger once. Then create the second number object and place it to its original position. Let's test it. Step 11. Create the second text input and put it on the scene. Step 12. Create another scene number variable. I'm gonna name my variable timer value M. Step 13. Create the third number object, put it on the scene and connect it to timer value M variable. Step 14. Create the second input button and put it on the scene. Just make it the same as the first input button. Step 15. When the second input button is pressed, connect the timer value M variable to the second text input. Step 16. When the timer value S is equal to 59, subtract 1 to timer value M. Set it to trigger once. Step Step 17. When the timer value S is equal to 0 and the timer value M is not equal to 0, wait 1 second and set the timer value S to 59. Now let's test it. Step 18. For 10 of minutes, just make it the same as tens of seconds. Let's test it. Step 19. Create the fifth number object and create a new scene number variable for the fifth number object. I'm gonna name my variable, timer value H. Step 20. When the timer value M and timer value S is equal to 59, subtract 1 to timer value H. Set it to trigger once. Step 21. When the timer value M and timer value S is equal to 0 and timer value H is not equal to 0, wait 1 second and set the timer value M and timer value S to 59. Connect the fifth number object to timer value H variable. Step 22. Create the third text input and create the third input button. Just make it the same as before. Step 23. When the third input button is pressed, connect timer value H to the third text input. Now let's test it. Step 24, for tens of hours, just make it the same as tens of minutes. Let's test it. Step 25, create the 7th number object and place it next to the 6th number object. Step 26, when the timer value H is greater than 99, change the X position of the 5th number object to the 7th number object. Delete the 7th number object. Step 27, when the timer value H is greater than 9 and less than 100, change the X position of the 5th number object to the 6th number object. Set it to trigger once. Then create the 7th number object and place it in its original position. Now let's test it. And that is how you made input timer in Gdevelop. Thank you guys for watching. If you want to download the app from the beginning of this video, just click the link in the description.